Yo, what's good YouTube? This is Jay from TNJ. And make sure you hit that like button because we are now talking about our players of the game after our first win last year, last game, and it feels good to be 1-0 to start this season. So we're starting out. I mean, was there any debate? Jimbo Brown gets the player of the game. He was a monster through the air, on the ground, almost 100 yards rushing, 3 receptions, 31, 2 big key third down receptions for us. So he's doing his thing. And then, I mean, don't sleep on Javier Garcia. I mean, this guy had a 73-yard rushing game. So we had two backs over 70 yards for the first time in this dynasty. And then also, you know who gets the player of the game on offense as well? The offensive line. They all get a plus one in awareness, and they had a pretty good offensive game. But looking at right guard was interesting because throughout that game, you saw that a lot of my big runs were to the left side, and it was right behind the big left guard, Odong Okon. And the thing is, I need to be able to run to the right side. And you know, I looked at Luke Balling a little bit, and Luke Balling actually had a pretty good year last year, only gave up 2 sacks. And I think I'm gonna give him the start. He is the senior and Kareem Lakes is the junior here, but he has better awareness, and I think that I can rely on him to open up holes on the right side. I need to be able to run on both sides of the ball. So we're gonna make that switch this game. So looking at the defense, you know, it was kind of a toss-up. You know, Ryan Marshall did have 10 tackles last game, but you know, the thing is, I was just too impressed with Brandon Jones. I mean, in the slot, this guy was just a monster. And he doesn't even, that's what's funny, he doesn't even start. He's actually listed as our 4th cornerback, but when he came in the game, I mean, he came in with energy, providing a lot of spark, and he's going to get that attribute boost. But you see, like, a lot of these guys are already getting boosts on their own. You see they're already going up plus one awareness just for getting in and making plays. So that's a pretty good thing to see right now. And look at Anthony Lorenz, he's already at 79 awareness, already plus one already on the season. So we're going into this matchup, and this is gonna be a tough matchup. So we are going up against South Carolina already. So Jake Bentley is back for his senior season. Last season, you see he threw 19 touchdowns, 6 interceptions. And this season, he's already got 2 touchdowns already. So we got to look out for him. And then their running back, A.J. Turner, is back. He's 92 overall. I mean, they are just overpowered with guys over us right now. Rico Dowell. Dowdle is actually their backup, and he's pretty fast as well. I mean, these guys are monsters. And on the receiving end, they don't really have a great star. I mean 87 overall is pretty good, but I mean, as far as just like guy that could take over the game, they don't have that guy. But you know, a guy that's it's pretty surprising, Bernard Davis is actually their leading tackler. He's a freshman, 6'2", 227. We gotta watch out for this guy. He is a true freshman. And then look at this, their second leading tackler already is Keith Wade, another true freshman at strong safety. So they have a couple of true freshmen that look like they are going to be stars one day. But looking at their defensive tackle here, Javon Kinlaw, I mean, this guy is a monster. 90 awareness, 89 strength, 90 power moves. It's going to be tough to run against this team. I mean, they have athletes all over the field. And looking at, you know, who they played last week and how they did, they are 1-0 on the season. They beat ECU 26-14, and ECU is in our conference, and they only beat them by 2 scores. So maybe we do have an opportunity in this game, and we are at home. Last year we went to their home, now we're at home. So this is going to be a really tough matchup, but I mean, building off of what we did last week, I think we can put up a pretty good game. And let's get into this action, man. Let's start this season outright. Can we upset them? Kirk Herbstreit is definitely going with them, but this is going to be a tough game at home. But let's get into this game. Let's get it. Let's go. So here we are starting off this game, and South Carolina is going to receive the kick, and there is Dowdle back to receive, and he's getting up close to about the 30-yard line. So here comes Jake Bentley, the senior at quarterback. And remember, he did a number on us last year. Will he do it again? So they start out this drive on the second play of the game at the 45 after a quick first down. throwing the ball deep as Bentley and already Shy Smith on the second play of the game, beating the defense. Xavier Davis getting beat deep on that one, and Terry couldn't get back as well, and that's already a seven-point game in this game. So here comes Coastal back out to receive this next kick. Remember, this true freshman, Allen King, did not redshirt him strictly because of his speed, his return ability. He gets a nice return. So here is this offense back out on the field. Jimbo Brown and Kashawn Curtin. Can they get going here in this game? Because we're going to need the offense. But here is Curtin missing a wide open curl route that time. So on a third and five, here he is rolling out right but getting hit as he gets rid of the ball. And that's going to be a quick three and out. So here comes South Carolina back out on offense. Here is Bentley throwing across the middle, finding Shy Smith, his favorite target. So now on a first and 10, close to the 40-yard line. Here he is giving it to Turner, and A.J. Turner can only get 4 yards on that one. So on a third and two here, trying to run the ball one more time with Turner, but this time Darius Terry is there for the 2-yard tackle for loss, and we force them to settle for a field goal. So that makes it a 10-point game already here within 3 minutes of this game starting. So now back out on offense. Here's Jimbo Brown. Can't get anything going. This SEC defense, we know they're going to be tough all game, but, you know, it's going to be – we're going to need this running game. So on a second and 10, here is Kashawn Curtin rolling out to the right side. So on a third and two, here is Angel Gonzalez, the redshirt freshman, getting the end around, and he's barely getting the first down. So now on a second and eight, a couple of plays later, here's Kashawn Curtin from the shotgun rolling out right. This time Justin Johnson burns his corner, gets open for the 20-yard reception on that one. And now that moves us past the 50-yard line as Max Moriarty on the next play gets open. And he is a matchup nightmare. He's going to be open all game, I hope. And on a first and 10, one more time, but the pressure is too much as they get in for the sack. Trying to get rid of the ball that time is Curtin, but taking a 14-yard sack. So on a second and 24 now, here's Max Moriarty getting open once again. So now on a third and 9, close to the 25-yard line, Curtin from the shot, going to throw out right. Nobody's open, so we're going to have to settle for the field goal. This one's from 43 yards out, and it's barely going to make it over the crossbar. And I think we found his limit. 43, 44 yards might be the longest that Leanne can kick from. So now back out on defense, 10-3 now. Here is Bentley one more time, throwing to Edwards on the outside, and Orlando Norman gets burnt on that one. And Brian Edwards makes it 33 yards up the field into our territory. So now on a first and 10, close to the 30-yard line, a slant route goes for 15 right back to Edwards. So now a minute left in this first quarter here. Bentley on a third and 4, throwing to the outside, but we do get them to settle for another field goal as Pollard can't stay in bounds, and that makes it a 13-3 game. So now here comes Curtin. Can we put up points before half, make this a manageable game going into halftime, but trying to run the ball? I mean, look at those white jerseys surrounding Jimbo Brown. He's not getting anything. Keith Wade on the tackle, the true freshman, as we try to throw the ball here on third down, and Amari Manuel just gets laid out on that one, but he does get a first down. So now on a first and 10 here on our own 25-yard line, finding Sam Forbes on the whip route, and that's going to be a manageable second and two as Jimbo Brown finally gets an open hole and gets 7 yards. So now on a third and 8 here, 4.5 minutes left in this first half, as we find Moriarty over the middle, and now we made it to the 50-yard line. So now here comes Curtin back out into the shotgun, fake handoff that time, dumping it over the line, Jack Kleck open, and that's 8 yards. So now here is Jimbo Brown finally in this second big run of this drive, 7 yards on that one, only 20 yards in the game so far. So now 3 minutes left in the second quarter, as here is Javier Garcia, the backup running back, getting in at receiver on a 5 wide and getting 9 yards. So on a second and 9, here is Curtin trying to throw to the outside. Justin Johnson could have been open on the out route, and could have got the first down, but we end up getting hit on the throw. So on a third and nine, here is Curtin one more time, feeling the pressure, and he's going to be swallowed that time by three or four South Carolina defenders. So we choose to go for it on this fourth down. It's out of field goal range and out of punting range, but that time Jack Klett can't hold on to it. So we do turn the ball over, and Bentley takes back over with 2 minutes left in this half as he, on the first carry, picks up 24 and probably could have broke that one. And the blocking is just on par for them in this first half as Bentley throws to the outside, finding Ortre Smith, and that's going to be 8 yards. So on a second and two, here they are running a screen pass, but Darius Terry, he had a pick six in his hands that could have changed the momentum of this game, but instead they get a second win is on a third and two on the very next play. Here is Bentley taking it 36 yards for the touchdown. And if Darius Terry would have came up with that interception, that could have changed the momentum as they choose as we come back out and kick the ball deep. But look at Alan King. He fumbles the ball, fumbles the kickoff as it's coming into his arms, and it's right on the 1 yard line. What a mistake by the true freshman. So we have to start this next drive out on the 1 yard line, but running a read option is Curtin, and he does pick up 10 yards to get us out of dangerous territory. So now a minute left in this half. Here he is finding Justin Johnson, and the freshman Justin Johnson is having a nice few catches. I mean, he's doing pretty well. So on a first and 10 here, a minute left. Oh, and he's taking a big hit over the middle that time. So on a second and 10, trying to throw the ball over the middle one more time, but Jack Kleck this time can't hold on to it. This SEC defense jarring the ball loose on back-to-back plays. But on a third and 10, here is Kashawn Curtin overthrowing Angel Gonzalez there, and that is going to be a pick there. So now here comes Bentley back on offense, giving it to A.J. Turner on a screen pass. And A.J. Turner gives Cedric Granger a mean stiff arm and makes it inside the 15-yard line. So now on a first and 10, there is A.J. Turner one more time, putting his head down and getting in for the touchdown. As big A.J. Turner, he just cannot be taken down as they take the 27-3 lead going into halftime. So now coming back out on in the second half, you can see their defense only 139 yards given up, two sacks, a pick, and they're doing a pretty good job of shutting down this offense as Jimbo Brown already takes a big hit, and he's already big as himself. And I mean, he takes a big one on there right there. So on a third and three, the pass hasn't been working on third down, so we attempt to run the ball, and look who's there. The true freshman, Keith Wade, as he makes the stop that time. And we have to punt the ball back to South Carolina. And here comes Jake Bentley back out to start this second half, getting it out to A.J. Turner. And he's bullying his way for a first down on that one. So here comes Bentley giving it to Turner one more time. And look at this blocking. Wide open up the middle, and we are not going to stop A.J. Turner as another big carry on that one. 51 yards up the middle for the touchdown, and just like that, this game is broken wide open 34-3 as we just need to put together a drive. I mean, give our offense, give our quarterback some confidence. So now on a second and inches here on a play action fake, here is Sam Forbes getting open for 7 yards. So now on a first and 10 at our own 35, here is Kashawn Curtin throwing to the outside, and Sam Forbes getting past the 50-yard line for the nice reception that time. But on a second and 10, throwing to the outside is Amari Manuel, taking a huge hit on that one. But on a third and 4, here is Amari Manuel on the quick screen and getting open for 7 yards. So now we're in business past the 40-yard line in their territory. Here is Justin Johnson. He's been all over the field this game. If there's one good thing that's happened to our offense, it's been Justin Johnson in this game as Jack Kleck once again drops his third pass of the game, and now facing a third and 10. Here is Curtin one more time rolling out, just trying to get something going, and he just throws it up for grabs, but luckily that isn't intercepted. But we do have to settle for the field goal because we're not going for it on fourth down the way our offense has been moving the ball. So now here comes Bentley back on offense, and we finally get an opportunity to get a sack, but Bentley gets rid of it. So now on a third and six here, 2 minutes left in this third quarter, but look, I mean, just wide open over the middle is Brian Edwards for 16 yards, and that's going to be an easy first down here for Bentley. So now on a first and 10, here is Shai Smith once again, another big reception for the favorite target of Bentley, and on the next play, running a read option, Bentley is going to stutter step, and he's going to make a move and have a clear lane for the touchdown as Coastal down 41-6 in this game. And it just shows that, you know, our team just isn't ready for this SEC competition as Justin Johnson gets another reception for 15 yards that time. But, I mean, like I said, I mean, this offense, it's just not ready for this defense, to be honest, as we try one deep and Justin Johnson doesn't even jump for it, and that's an easy interception and the second turnover of the game from Keshawn Curtin as Bentley comes back out. Almost a sack on that one, but Otre Smith that time gets open for the 24-yard gain. But Bentley, here he comes once again on the read option, but Cedric Granger is going to be there for the tackle. Not many bright spots for this defense, but I mean, what can you say? Going up against South Carolina, we got blown out by them last year, and this year looks like much of the same as A.J. Turner once again gets an open hole and almost breaks that one there. Only goes for 12 yards. But now we decide to sub in our second team offense and defense, get them some looks here to start the fourth quarter. Here's A.J. Turner getting swallowed up that time by Sergi Rivera, a guy that doesn't really touch the field, but he's pretty good. And here on a third and inches, here is Bentley one more time throwing out a stiff arm and running it in 26 yards. And it doesn't look like they're taking their foot off the gas pedal at all. I mean, they're leaving in all their starters. And what do you know? I mean, they score another touchdown. But here is Wesley David in at quarterback, our backup, as he misses a wide open Angel Gonzalez on that one. And one more time, that one was actually to Sam Forbes on the outside. It looked like it was to the slot, but it was actually to the outside. But on a third and 10, I mean, these throws are just so bad. That one wasn't even close to the curl route, and we do have to punt this ball away. So after a great return, you see they have great field position. Still, Bentley is in the game as they are just still airing the ball out. And here is Edwards one more time getting 15 yards, and that's going to be another first down for this South Carolina offense as A.J. Turner. I mean, this guy can't be stopped. I'm hoping that Jimbo Brown can have the impact like this on this offense going into conference play as one more time. Rico Dowdle gets in for the touchdown, and that's going to be the game. 62-13 ends up being the final score here. We do score a garbage time touchdown by Javier Garcia as he gets 16 yards in this game. Jimbo Brown, 14 attempts for 42 yards. Very, very quiet. He actually had 12 yards after contact, which is actually pretty good. I think the one good thing we can take away from this game is how to use Justin Johnson. I can use his speed on a lot of crossing routes, I think, and he's just getting integrated into the offense. But Jack Kleck had three drops, and that's something that we can't have going into conference play. We got to get some better play out of Jack Kleck. And on the defensive side, not many good things to say. You know, this pass rush has just not been getting any sacks this season, and that's something we need to address going forward. Hopefully the team can pick it up going into conference play, going up against Louisiana Monroe next week, and we're on the road. So to open up conference play, it's going to be kind of a tough game. So here we go. Hit subscribe, hit that like button, because we got to get going. We got our butts whooped. We got to come back and see what we got. So stay tuned. Let's get it. Let's go.